Welcome to Digital Principles and System Design. In this video lecture, let's discuss about some of the circuits available in ALU. Let's see what is binary multiplier. We are given two binary numbers and we are supposed to get the product of them. Assume that we have a multiplier A, which is 2-bit long, and we have a multiplicand B, which is also 2-bit long. Now when we multiply the multiplicand with 1 bit of the multiplier. That is, we multiply B1, B0 with A0. And we get the partial product A0, B1, which is 1 bit, and A0, B0 is another bit. And similarly, we will multiply the multiplicand B1, B0 with A1. And get the partial product A1, B1, A1, B0. Now we will add these two things. This partial product will be shifted one position to the left, and this bit will be directly written here. And we will add these two bits, and the sum is written here. The carry of the addition will be added with this bit, and we get the sum and the carry. Let's now realize this multiplication as a hardware. When we multiply the multiplicand with the multiplier A0, this is actually the AND operation. These two bits we get by the AND of B1 A0, and similarly the AND operation between A0 and B0. So we have two AND gates for which we supply the multiplier bit A0, and we multiply this with or make an AND with B0 and B1, and this bit we can directly give it to the output since there is only one bit. So we are giving this to the output. Now this bit we have to add it with this one, and to generate this one we need to have two more AND gates which will be making an AND operation between A1, B1 and A1, B0. So A1, B1 is generated by this AND gate, and A1, B0 is generated by this AND gate. And we need to add this bit with this one. Since there is only two bits, we can use a half adder to add these two bits. So we have a half adder which accepts one bit, which is A0, B1, that comes from this AND gate, and this AND gate gives A1, B0, and these two bits are added using the half adder. And with half adder we have two outputs, the sum and the carry. The sum can appear as the output, and the carry of this half adder has to be passed on to this position. So we will supply this, the carry of the half adder, to the next half adder, and this will add the bit A1, B1 with the carry of the previous addition. Again we have only two bits to add, so we can use another half adder to generate the sum and the carry. And this is how we realize the multiplier. The problem with this circuit is that this circuit is capable of adding only two bits at a time because we are using a half adder. Suppose if the multiplier had three bits long, that is we have one more bit, say A2 here, then we will have another partial product that will start from here and goes here. Now we might, and similarly suppose if we have one more bit here as well in the multiplicand, then we will have one bit here, we'll have another bit here, and we will have three bits to add at this position. Okay, so then that means that this half adder will not be able to perform the addition. So we need to modify the circuit that will suit any general n bit multiplication. Let's generalize the multiplication. Assume that we have j bits in the multiplier and there are k bits in the multiplicand. So how many AND gates we will require to perform a multiplication between two numbers in which one is j bit long, the other is k bit long. The number of AND gates will be equal to the multiplication of the number of bits between these two things, because every bit in the multiplicand has to be multiplied by every bit in the multiplier. So we will have JK AND gates each for generating each bit in the partial product. And how many partial products we will get? For each bit in the multiplier, we will get one partial product. So there will be J partial products here. And how many bits we will have in each of the partial product? Each of the partial product will have K number of bits. How many additions we should perform to get the final product? If there are K rows, then we have to add K bits together. So instead of performing the individual column sum, we can consider this as one partial product and this as another partial product shifted, and we can add, we can directly give this one, and we can append 0 here and perform addition of two partial products which are k bits long. How many bits will be there in each partial product? The number of bits will depend on the number of bits in the multiplicand. So if we have a k bit multiplicand, the number of bits in each of the partial product will be k bit. So we can think of adding two partial products which are k bit long. So the configuration of the adder will be k bit adder. And how many adders we will have? Since there are j partial products, we will require j minus 1 adder, and each adder is k bit binary adder. That is what is given here. The number of partial products is j. That depends on the, for each multiplier bit we will get a partial product, and the number of bits in the partial product depends on the multiplicand, which is k bits long. So the configuration of the binary adder will be k bit adder. And how many adders we will need? How many k bit adders we need? We need j minus 1 k bit adders. And the final product will have j plus k product bits. And this is a circuit that performs multiplication of a multiplier having 3 bits and the multiplicand having 4 bits, B0 to B4. So multiplicand has 4 bits and multiplier has 3 bits. So how many partial products we will have? We will have 3 partial products, and the number of adders will be 2, which is 3 minus 1, and the configuration of the adder is 4 bit long, which is the number of bits in the multiplicand. And number of gates will be 3 into 4, which is 12. So we have 4 AND gates here, 4 AND gates here, 4 AND gates here, totally 12 AND gates. So we multiply A0, B0, and we directly give the result. And this A0, B1, A0, B2, A0, B3, they are supplied as one input along with MSB0. Okay, to one input of the adder. The other input is the other partial product with A1, all B bits with A1. So this is like a shift, right? So we have this bit in the output, and next 3 bits MSB is now going to act as 0, and this is added to the next partial product. The result of this, the sum, the least significant bit in the sum will appear in the output. The next 3 bits along with the carry will act as the input to the next adder, and the other input to the adder will be the other partial product, all the bits of B multiplied with A2 is supplied as input to the adder. The output of all these, so it's a 4-bit adder, right? So we have 4-bit sum and 1 carry. If the number of bits in the multiplier is more, then this carry will be going as input to the next adder, and we can extend this circuit. We will end the discussion of arithmetic circuits in the ALU. In the next video lecture, we will discuss about one logical operation, which is the comparison. And division operation is a complex circuit which you will learn in detail when you learn the computer architecture. Thank you for watching this video.